Big, cool, this new condition, appreciate it. we're organizing here at the Lima Wildlife Center a workshop on wildlife arts focusing on the Cross River Gorilla. Why on the Cross River Gorilla? Because this is the most threatened African primate, and today it numbers around 300 in the wild. So there's a need to continuously raise public attention and the need to find alternative means to involve them in the conservation and protection of the habitats of this species. So today in Limbe, we have brought together several Cameroonian artists who are focusing on drawing the Cross River Gorilla, and which will be now be sent to different communities, both locally, nationally, and internationally, to raise awareness and equally to raise the necessary funds with which to conduct these conservation activities in the field.
When you say the Cross River Gorilla is the most threatened, what are you talking about? What is that? What does that mean?
The first thing that comes to mind is the number. Today they are numbered less than 300 in the wild, and if compared to other gorilla subspecies in Africa, they are the least represented. So endangered, threatened in terms of their numbers and in terms of their habitats.
You know, the immediate community, those who are supposed to protect the gorillas, are not here. What is the message you're sending out to them?
Even though they're not here, we just recently visited some of these communities, and we ran some of the same activities with the school children. So we are hoping that eventually we'll get to all of the communities, conduct the same kind of workshops, and continue to raise the awareness and the need why they need to protect these animals. So the message I'm sending out is simply that they need to get involved, they need to work alongside us, and together we will look for alternative means that we'll use to save these last species of primates. And this particular method has been used successfully in Eastern and South Africa by Danitello, a Caribbean-based wildlife artist that is working on this program on an international scale. And also it's important focusing on it because it's an alternative means of raising money without passing through the conventional donut bay approach, where we have to have several different partners or organizations approach the same donut or the same pot of money. And as every day goes by, the number of partners involved in these activities increase, and the same amount of money, instead of increasing, is decreasing. Consequently, we need alternative means which do not simply rely on approaching the same dollar.